We are back at it again with another video review. And this time, it's a close homie of the show, none other than James Bama Hardy in the classic Ride the Sky.
Woo!
Hardy, the big homie. This is the part that made me fall in love with the man skating. Little did we know we'd fall in love with him as a homie years later. Mm-hmm. Fucking love this part, man. It's clean as fuck. Let's get into it.
This is the perfect gnarly part that we needed, man. This gnar score is going to go through the roof. But let's not get ahead of ourselves. Style is up first. Ain't nobody skating rails the way Bama Hardy does it with that effortless style. We're talking some clean, fakey 5-0s on rails. Are you kidding me, dog? It's going to be a 9.5 for me.
I mean, I feel like I can't go any lower because then he's going to call me saying I'm a hater. And if I go higher, then fans are going to say I'm sucking up. So I'm going to go 9.5 as well, man. He's just clean as they come.
Everything is clean, man. You said it when we were watching it. The tailside kickflip, the front blunt on that hubba. Every clip in this is clean. Not one blemish, man.
Bro, Gnarblade, what are you thinking, bro?
Oh, what do you mean, what am I thinking, dog? It's a 10. This the sharpest Gnarblade in the game, dog.
Yeah, it's like you were saying earlier before we smashed record. Skating gnarly shit and making it look good is one of the hardest things to do. And he's an absolute master at that. I'm going to give him a 10 for Gnarblade.
It's too easy, man. Next up, Tech. What do you think was the techest clip in this part, dog?
Maybe the 180 switchback 5-0 on that classic SD outledge. That was a...
Yeah, I would say that. Or the tailside kickflip.
Back blunt kickflip. Not the techest guy, obviously. Yeah, I don't know. I just love how he mixes it up. Switch trays, nollie trays. Doing some gnarly. He's a good tech gnar guy. You know what I'm saying? Front blunt shoving rails. Mm-hmm. He's tech gnar, but on the gnar side. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely leans heavily on the gnar side. For Tech Blade, I hate to do it to you, but I'm going with a 6.
Hey. Can't be mad at that.
Man, it hurts. I don't want to give him anything lower than an 8 because he's the dog, man. It hurts. It hurts my heart. Yeah. But we gotta be fair.
You know what? Yo, Hardy, fam. You fucking think I'm just going to give you blessed scores because we're boys and shit? Bro, front big spins? Get the fuck out of here with that shit. I'm giving you a 5.5 for Tech.
Oh, you made it sound like you were going to do something like astronomical. This guy went a half point lower than me. The fuck out of here. Next up, it's Transition. He had a couple clips, skated a gap into the bank. Like you said, he did the blunt side kickflip. So there wasn't absolutely no transition. Oh, there was also that bank to ledge with the backsmith shove.
Yeah, ollie.
Couple clips. Oh, ollie into that big bank. You're right. But he definitely is no Grant Taylor. I gave Sinner a 5. I'm going to do the same for James.
Same here, man. It's I'm going to give him a fucking 5.5. No, I'm going to give him a 6 just for that kickflip. It's one of the most beautiful kickflips of all time off the bump over the grass gap. And he does that back 5-0 front shove into the bank. He gets a 6 from me.
Oh, look at you, dog. You are getting called out for sucking up.
Shit.
Yeah, that's for sure. Next up, it's Bag of Tricks. Trick selection. For a handrail skater, he's got all the good ones, man. Backsmith. Does back 180 nose grinding, huge hubbas. Front blunts, like I said, love them. I'm going to hit him with, and the fakie ollie switchback 50. Damn, that's a trick you don't see too often
round
on
rails.
He went both ways on that fakie 50-50. I'm going with a 7.
A 7? Yo, that's disrespect to my mans, yo. I'll slap the shit out of you.
Okay, you have to listen here. We're fucking putting this up against parts like Stevie in the DC video. If we go ahead and give James Hardy a 95 out of 100 and we're hitting Stevie with 83, have some respect for yourself.
Some respect,
Ghost.
For myself? Yo, trick selection?
For yourself.
This fool fucking front heels a double out of nowhere when he's more of a kick flipper. Nollie back heels a long double. Fakie 5-0-ing big ass round handrails. And yo, when he hits you with that tray flip and then mirror switch tray on that fucking grass gap, like, yo, I'll slap the shit out of you when this quarantine's over. I'm giving my guy
I highly doubt that.
I'm giving my guy a 9 for trick selection. Actually 9.5.
I knew you were going with the 9.5. You paused there, you son of a bitch. Next up, kits. James Hardy. For the times, these kits were perfectly on point. He had the fall-ins, mix it in with the kind of tight pants, kind of loose pants, shoelace belt, couple ill Bama t-shirts going on. I can't hate on the kits for him. It was a perfect match. I'm going to give him an 8 for his kits.
Nice. Yeah, can't go wrong. You know what I'm saying? Classic little hungry skater kits. But he rocked an Africa t-shirt in one of them. And those two Bama shirts, I got to give him an 8.5 for kits.
Dude, you're so... Fuck you, man. You know we're going next. It's filming. We're talking high-speed lines, long lens on some big rails, big doubles, all the clips looking absolutely flawless. No problem with the filming here. I'm going to give him a 9.
Yo, same here. I was just going to say, you know, after watching Sinner and then watching this, this part is so well filmed. It really jumps out at you. I think it's a VX part, right? Mm-hmm. I'm watching with these weird-ass glasses.
Definitely looks it.
Yeah, I'm going to give him a 9 for filming, too. This shit was crispy. Props to whoever filmed this part. Song and edit, bruv. What are you saying?
Classic song, little Lynyrd Skynyrd, going perfectly with the skating and the edit. I like everything about this part. Not only is our homie, you can't deny what this part brought to skating. I'm sticking with the high scores. I'm going with another 9.
I like it. Yeah, man. This part is another one of those examples of when the whole video is so gnarly and kind of long, they can kind of get swept under the rug. Always felt like this part didn't get the shine it fully deserved. But yeah, song and edit, I'm going to go with 8.
You went underneath me. Are you sure you want to do that? You don't want to step me up?
Nah, I'm sure, man. That song ain't good? My vibe. The edit's great, though. 8 is all good with me.
Next up, overall continuity. I mean, it matches together so perfect. The whole video went together, had a theme to it. It was one of the gnarliest videos at the time. Still is, holding weight to this day. This part's an absolute classic. Overall continuity is perfect. I'm sticking with the 9s, man. That's 3 in a row for me.
Okay. Triple 9s, eh? Overall continuity. Yo, he skates a lot of Cali spots, but I like his spot selection. They're not just boring spots. He's got some Bama, I think. You know what I'm saying? A little SD. Overall continuity. His kits are pretty similar all the way throughout. It has a great feel overall. I'm giving him a 9. You know what time it is, bruv. It's Enders. You get me.
It's Ender time, baby. The last little bit of this part is absolutely bananas. We're talking about the fakie 50-50s and then finishing it off with the overcrooks of Sin. You know, James did his little patented shoulder shrug when he's coming out of there just to let you know he's steezy as a motherfucker. I've been pretty harsh on the Enders from day one. I haven't given anyone over. I haven't gone into the 10s. And I don't think I can do it with James, but I'm going to give him a 9, man. He finished strong. Hardy, bro. Killed it.
I feel you. Wait up for 1 second. I need to count the stairs. I was about to give him a lower score. But now I'm thinking, if this is the 20 stair that... What's that? What's the other homie's name who frontside flipped it, I think? No, there's a small 20. It is. Breaking news. It's a 20 stair. It's the 20 stair that Tommy Gunn's frontside flipped.
This guy's just broke news. Breaking news. Holy fuck.
Yo. No, okay. Well, I just broke news to myself. I was actually going to give him a fucking, like, 7.5 just because it nose grind like a bland San Diego rail. It never like jumped out at me as like the gnarliest trick or the best way to end that part. But there's something too clean about skating a 20 stair. And so I'm going to give him a 9 for Ender. Nose grind to 20. Jesus.
That is insane. Goddamn 20 stairs. All right. You know what time it is. Tally up them scores, motherfucker. Yeah.
I think I got my score if I can do math.
All right. What'd you give him? We're talking about the homie here.
Oh, wait. I think I got it wrong. 75 plus. All right, yo. This just in. The homie Hardy, 83.5.
Holy shit. That's a big score, baby. I didn't come in too far behind that. Mine came in at 81.5, just 1 point lower than Stevie's part in the DC video. Overall classic, man.
Yeah, I guess this scoring system doesn't necessarily reflect impact on skateboarding. Like we said, it's very imperfect, but personal preference. Somehow, I guess this got the same score I think I gave Garcia.
You can't fault the system for that. Bama, you got what you deserve, baby. One of the greatest parts one of our homies ever dropped.
Real shit. Enough respect, blood.